Welcome back, YouTube. Today we're going to be working with Cerrosafe chamber casting alloy from Brownell's. Chamber casting alloy you can use for quite a few different gunsmithing ventures. One of the most common things, of course, is doing a chamber cast. The point behind doing a chamber cast is when you have a firearm that you're not sure what the caliber is and you want to safely identify it as easily as possible. This will allow you to take precise measurements when you have to make an exact casting of the chamber. That way you can get an idea how much free bore you got. You can slug your bore with it. So in the course of this video, we're going to do a chamber casting on an original M91 barreled action, Mosin barreled action. And we're also going to do, if that one's not counterbored, we'll go ahead and do a slugging from the muzzle end, and we'll give us an idea what our overall bore diameter is on this thing. This is can be used as an alternative to traditional slugging with a round ball. Let's get started. All right, you're gonna need a few basic tools. It helps to have a ladle, like you see in the middle of the frame, a brass jag that you can push your patch in and out of. You'll see that in a second. I've got a can of Ballistol here just for wiping down with oil in between various actions here. Of course, you're going to need your chamber casting alloy. I have a little toothbrush for scrubbing loose particles away if I need to. I've got a small temperature gun here that we're going to use to keep control of the temperature as close as possible. The reason you want to do that is because if you get this Cerrosafe too hot, it will begin to separate and it'll get all clumpy. You don't want that. You'll need a propane cylinder or other similar heat source to heat the chamber casting alloy. And you'll need a barreled action or appropriately disassembled rifle of whichever type you're going to use, or pistol, in order to do your chamber cast on. So we're going to go ahead and remove the bolt and we're going to get started. Okay, what I've done here to get us started, I've gone ahead and I've driven a Tipton coated cleaning rod into the barrel with a cleaning patch on our jag. And basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to heat the action up much in the same way that you would heat up, say, a bullet mold, except we're just not getting it that hot. And I'm going to go ahead and pour the bullet casting alloy in there. We're going to get a chamber cast. Bear with me. It's hard to work with the camera because this is kind of a three-handed operation as it is. I've got a vise here to help me hold the barrel in place. I've got the propane torch set for a very delicate flame. You can barely see it coming out. You don't want to overheat this stuff. Just got my ladle. And we're just going to heat this stuff up till it's molten. I've already heated the receiver just a little bit to get it warm, because I know the process under which I do all this, I'm going to be kind of limited for the time frame I have to pour this stuff. It solidifies pretty quick. Once you pour this stuff, you need to have it out of the rifle before about the half hour passes by, because it will expand to the point where it's difficult to remove from the rifle. And basically you have to treat this stuff like you're working with a bullet mold and you're working with lead pretty much. So I'm going to heat this stuff up and get it molten. Hopefully you can see in the camera fairly well there. I mean, this stuff, melts pretty quick. It doesn't take a whole lot of temperature. You don't want to apply the heat rapidly. You want to apply the heat nice and slow and give it time to come up to temperature slowly and melt slowly. Don't apply the heat directly to the metal, like right on it like that, if you can help it, okay? So I'm going to do this, and I'll show the pouring. All right, now this part right here is going to require a pretty good bit of precision, because you don't want to pour the chamber casting alloy into the locking lugs, because then you're never going to get your chamber cast out, okay? You got to kind of look up in there, and you want to pour it to where it's kind of flush with the back of the receiver a little bit. You just really have to do it a few times to see what I'm talking about. I mean, it's going to be impossible for me to show you on the camera. But basically what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take my little ladle here. All right. Just going to pour it in there. All right, not there yet. Getting close. You just kind of have to pour and check. All right, a little further, but see, since our receiver's warm, we don't have to worry about it setting up on us too quick. and we should be able to get a pretty accurate chamber casting. I believe that's probably going to work right there. All right, we're going to let this sit up for probably about 10 minutes, and we're going to punch it out, see what our chamber casting looks like. If I have to repeat the process, I will. But, I mean, if you're identifying the, see, like right now, this alloy is molten, and I'm holding it with my hands. So it melts at, you know, low temperature. It's not like lead. Anyway, if we have to do this again, we will, but I think we're going to get a successful chamber casting here. We'll go ahead and pop this guy out in a minute, and we'll see what it looks like. All right, so we were able to get our chamber cast out of the rifle. This particular chamber cast right here, if you were taking dimension measurements to whether you were going to set up like reloading dies or something like that and wanted to know, you know, the exact dimensions of your chamber, this particular cast wouldn't be good enough. But in terms of me identifying what caliber this rifle is, I think we can all agree that it's a 7.62 by 54 rimmed. Of course, going into this, I knew that. This casting here would be good enough to identify the caliber of the firearm. We're going to go ahead and do a basic casting of probably about the first 2 inches of the muzzle and get an idea of the overall bore diameter. But hopefully this covers it in a nutshell. This isn't meant to be like extremely precise, this particular one. This is just to confirm the caliber of a firearm. Of course, we can tell this is, you know, what this is by a few basic measurements. Anyway, this can be melted down and reused again, so that's what we're about to do. Okay, this particular casting, we're just gonna get a section that's around probably the first 2 inches of the muzzle end of the rifle. And this one should be a little easier to show you what I'm doing here. We're just heating the ladle up, getting our alloy molten so we can pour in the barrel. This alloy is up to 160 degrees. All right, so that's going to be perfect for what we're doing. I've got it dammed up about a little lower than what you see in the frame of the camera. And we're going to go ahead and just pour a little alloy in there. Ooh, there we go. Well, I got it all down the side of the barrel, but not a problem. It just flakes right off. What I like to do is take a dental pick and sort of probe. And that gives us an idea how soft or hard it's gotten. All right, so we've gotten our casting out of the muzzle end of the rifle. As you can see, we've done about the first couple of inches of rifling. Hopefully this will show up good. But you see the definite rifling indentations, the lands and grooves. Okay. Now, we're going to treat this just like we would a standard bore slugging. And we're just going to measure and see the size of the lands and grooves we're working with. So the grooves, that's our measurement for the grooves, the lands mic out at 310, 311, let's see,